Hello. Today I'm going to show you how to fix a busted radiator baseboard heater. Okay. Because of the cold weather, I didn't turn it off. I didn't bleed it, winterize it. So, as you can see, there's a botch here showing that it's busted, and I got one on that other end. So all we go do is cut that, and actually the whole radiator is not damaged, it's just that end part. That's the good thing. So that's all we need to repair. It's that part. First, let me take it out this side first to show you. Because it's also busted on that side. And here, it's busted, so we'll cut it. Got this size cut the other side. And I'm going to show you the damage. I want to remove that whole copper anyway. This whole copper anyway. Okay. So I'm going to show you how to run it. Don't throw it away and get yourself a new one, because these are over $100. So don't waste your money, because as you can see, there's a hole here on this side and there's a leak on this side right here. So you can't reconnect it because the damage already been done. What you want to do, you see these aluminum? Go on this side first. You see the aluminum here? All you need to do is disconnect it and put it back on. For you to disconnect it, you can take this off, disconnect it. You can rip it off. This guard thing, you don't even really need it here. easy. Okay, there you are. You don't really need it. Okay. Now I got that much space to work with. Okay. Rip the aluminum off. Got that much space to work with. And now, what I want to do is cut that off. See? Now you got that. Got that much of damage done. See the hole? Really good. We'll just remove that. Back on. Now on this side, you turn. See, so ripped. What do I want to do first? Take that off. That's all you need. Then just couple it. Alright. Put this back on. You all need to put it back on. It's just a cover right here, but somehow it's stuck on this one. You need to put it back on. So this. So this. This side. You got your one right there. All you need to do, start it back. sure. Okay. Now you want to connect that through here. You see? That's it. That's how you repair a damaged baseboard water heater. All you need to do is take some aluminum off and you're good to go. As you can see, it's a little cold in the house. Alright. Thank you for watching my video. If you like, please subscribe. I appreciate it. Alright, thank you.